Hello friends, my name is Shivam from DevOps Schools and I will help you to enable your learning process in various technologies of DevOps, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data and many more. This is our initiative to help you by sharing multiple tutorials and videos. And if you want any specific tutorials on any particular topic, then please do comment in the below comment section and I will help you with it. Also, please subscribe to our premium services on YouTube, which will give you access to more content and videos to enhance your knowledge about all these topics. Also, if you want me to help you with regards to the online trainings and classroom sessions by our qualified trainers, then please write me at contact@devopsschool.com. Thank you.
Angular part. But development perspective, right? Angular is always the preferred choice because of framework. People, did you get the point or not? It's not like that, you know, now why they have not taken care about the performance part. Yes, nowadays they have taken care about the performance part. And for that purpose, right, the main benefit that will get it from the module, how to perform this modularity and all, right, we'll have a discussion for the same. Did you get the moral of the story? When we'll deal with the React, right, performance is the always best because of library. But when you'll deal with the Angular, right, development is faster compared with the React. First point. Second thing is, now what is the major drawback is the performance. Have they taken care about it? Yes, they have taken care about it. They have taken care about the performance with the help of a concept called lazy loading of your modules. Now people tell me, lazy loading always, will it be preferred in development or not? People, when you develop anything, right, will you prefer the lazy loading, right?
It's preferred.
Yeah.
As and when required, bring the contents into the picture. If it is required, bring it. If not, leave it. Whenever it is required, we'll utilize it. Correct, everyone? So this is the benefit that we'll get it. Okay, next point. Now, here, just a second. Whatever the files that I'm creating at my end, right, end of the session, right, I'm going to share all the things with you. Okay, end of the session I'll share one Google Drive path where all your recordings, this Excel file, source codes and this draw.io file, everything I'm going to place. Is it clear, everyone? Recordings, right?
Yes, sure.
I'm going to okay, Google Drive location, so I'll share that location with you. You can download it at your end. Fine. Okay. Now, yeah. How will you go here?
Yeah.
You'll be sharing the recording of the session.
Yes, Raghunanda. Download recordings, right? I'm going to share it on the Google Drive. Okay. You can download it at your end directly. See, people tell me every page, every application is divided into three parts, right? Header, landing area, and footer, correct?
Correct.
You can take any application. Okay, for example, let's say I'll take Amazon. Have a look over here. This is the Amazon ka this complete navbar or header area. These are the landing contents, right? And this is the footer information, yes or no, the complete one.
Yeah.
Yes.
This is the complete footer information, right? So in short, I said, yeah, any application is divided into three basic parts, header, landing, and footer. Instead of I'm referring it here as a landing, that is, you can say the generic access area, you can say that based on your navigation, right? Your header is fixed, footer is fixed. Based on your navigation, landing contents will be changed. All of you agree with this or not?
Correct.
Okay. Next. Now, people, what is the purpose of your header? What are the contents will keep it into the header part? Company logo and navigation, right?
Yes.
And in the footer, again, we'll have a company logo and contact us and copyright contents, correct? Right, and here based on navigation, right, will render the contents. Okay, now here this is a basic building block for your any application. Okay, now first of all, we want to build the similar kind of thing for the application. Now for that purpose, people, we need HTML stuff and all, correct? So for that purpose, I'm going to share one github.com/ Just a second. Here it is, expecting some course. Okay, that I'll share it. People have shared one GitHub link with you. Did you get that? Everyone, did you get the link?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So there, right? There, right? What do you need to do? The first zip file. Are you able to see Dev Connector theme? Are you able to see this Dev Connector theme zip file, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
you have to download this file. You have to download this zip file, okay? So after extraction, right, you'll get this. Now here, I'll show you the actual content so that you can have a mapping between these two. People, once you are able, once you are done with the download part, right, then please let me know.
Yeah, it is complete.
Could you please extract it? Extract it, and once you are done with this extraction, right? All of you, once you are done with this extraction, right, go to the file menu. Go to the file menu. There, are you able to find out new window option?
Yes.
Yeah.
Click to it.
Okay.
Then click to open folder. Go to that extracted location and select the folder. Okay. People, are you able to see this landing.html over here? Or at your end?
Yes. Yeah.
Right click on this.
Yes.
And click on open with live server. Now people, is it showing this page over the localhost server or not? Now people, you have to tell me in our application, which one is the header content, which one is the landing content, and which one is the footer content.
Dev Connector
developers tab. Dev Connector developers sign up. That this gray colored bar, right? Add. Correct.
Yeah.
This one is your
header.
This one is the.
That's a header.
Header part. Correct. This one is the header part. Then this developers connector. This part is your.
This is your landing.
This is a landing content. And this one will be your footer content.
Footer, right.
Is this split up correct? Yes or no? Navbar, landing, and the footer. Got it, everyone?
Yes.
Okay, so people have a look over here. This is our actual contents, correct? This is what we are expecting. Now in this case, people tell me like this, you know, when I designed this page, right? In this page, are you able to find out the complete stuff, correct? You'll find out the navbar, that is navigational content, landing content, and the footer content. If we'll just have a look over here, agree or not?
Yes.
Next point. Now tell me, while developing a Java's application also, right? Well, can you bring entire application stuff? Can you write it inside the main method?
No.
Mm-hmm. Can I maintain a single file? Vithya?
Not with a single file.
I mean to say, I will have a single public class, and inside the main file only, right? I have the default classes. Will it work?
You mean entire the other project?
But we'll not follow this practice. Agree? We will write it.
Yeah.
There is no doubt. Okay, we can write it, but we will not do it. We'll prefer the modularity or not, everyone. That is, we'll separate our stuff with respect to packages and we'll complete the work. Like that also, here we want to follow the process. Now, when you are going to deal with this Angular-based stuff, correct? So at that time, what are the precautions that we should take it while dealing with the UI part? Whenever you design any Angular UI or UI part, at that time we should follow one principle. Okay, we should follow one principle. Whatever the UI part will design, that part should not be split into some other part. Now people tell me, in this situation, this navigational stuff, right? Can we split it into some other part? From the designing perspective, right? Can I say that this is the last limit? People, did you get the point or not?
No, can you repeat the question, Abhi?
See, what I'm trying to say, While designing the Angular application, right? We have to design the UI parts. Agree, everyone? We should design the UI parts in such a way that particular part should not split into some other part. From the split perspective, that would be a last limit. Now, why to prefer this expectation? Well, when you'll follow this expectation, right, we can have the good amount of reusabilities. We can do it. Okay, now in this case, this UI part I was talking about, correct? This UI part is referred as, hello? Yes?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, Gajalakshmi, tell me.
Yeah, so we should split into some other part, or we shouldn't?
No. Whatever the part you will design, right? That part should be the last split up with respect to your UI work. Is that clear, Gajalakshmi?
Yes.
So, for example, let's say, I mean to say, this entire stuff is my UI, right? Can I put it into a single file? I can do that. Can I put it into a single file? I can do that. But people tell me, for other pages also, right? Do you need navigation and do you need a footer part, right? So what you need to do? Again, you need to perform the rewriting work or not. Hello?
Yeah, that's right.
Again, you have to perform the rewriting work, right? Now people tell me, with respect to ease of maintenance or application development, can you prefer this option? You will not prefer this option, right? What is your expected one? Ease of maintenance and reusability. These are the, see, developing people, developing an application, it's not a big deal. We can do that anyways, but maintaining the application, that is our big pen, right? So from that perspective, we should follow this principle from the beginning itself. Whenever we design the application, we should design the application parts in such a way that whatever the amount of UI we want to design, whatever the amount of unit amount of UI you want to design, that unit amount of design should not split into some other part. Now, this unit amount of UI is referred as component. This unit amount of design is referred as a component. While designing a component, what is the need you should, you know, which thing you should follow? We should follow the things in such a way that whatever the component work that you will take it, that component work should not split into some other part. That would be a last limit. Now, why should I prefer this thing? People tell me, whatever the small units that will define it, right? Now people tell me, with respect to ease of maintenance and reusability, will it be beneficial for us or not?
Yes, that's a benefit.
Correct. So people, I'm not going to tell you this thing at the end. Okay, I'll design randomly anything. I will not do that. I will design randomly anything. And at the end, I'll put a point in front of you. Now people, with respect to ease of maintenance, we want to develop the components in this way. No, at the beginning only, right? I'll give the clarity that whenever we'll design the components, the component designing should be with respect to what? Whatever the design will do it, it should not split into some other parts. That would be a unique part. That's it. Clear? Now, based on this principle, right? People tell me here how many parts we should create it for our home page.
On a high level, it will be 3, that is the header, footer, and landing. But
that is fair enough.
Even this header can be split into the left pane or right pane based on the need.
Vithya, but if you know, in our application, right, with this call, right, you have to take from requirement to requirement. Okay, so here, if you are getting a lot of options like Amazon, if you'll get a lot of options like Amazon, yeah, right, yeah, then you go for the split ups. Got the point? If you want, we can do it in that way also. That is not a problem. Left pan, right pan, and these two things, we can combine it into the header. That is also a good designing part. There is no problem. Okay. So as of now, we'll consider this header as one part, correct? This dev connector specification, this is the landing part. I will consider the second part. And this footer will be a third part. All of you agree with this?
Okay. Yeah.
Correct. So in short, here, while designing this application part, right, I have to deal with how many parts? Here I have to deal with the 3 parts. One is, I would say, navbar, footer, and the landing. Clear, everyone?
Yeah.
Now, the most important thing,
So Abhinandan, so I just have a question.
Yes, Sumesh.
Yeah. So if at all in the future, okay, now we have decided and finalized there is only three splits. In future, if at all there is one more split, like within the footer, we want left and right. So what do we do at that time?
At that time, see, if you're getting a requirement like that, right? So only one thing is what you have to introduce two components, okay? And the stuff you have to migrate it. Thus, that whatever the stuff is there, right? You have to shift it.
Okay.
Thanks. You got the point. That is the last option, okay? That is the reason. So that is the reason I said. Well, you know, anyways, people are going to follow the agile methodology for the development, correct? So one, this purely depends on the requirement, okay? Now, why am I coming with a single one for my footer? The reason behind this is, if you look into my application stuff, right, it has only a message content, right, Umesh? It has only a copyright message, correct?
Got it.
Now, if you have few other parts, okay, then accordingly, na, you take the call. That is not a problem. But as of now, as per my requirement, I have this much of stuff. That's the reason I thought, instead of having the multiple parts, right, I'll go with the single part only, correct? Now, the next point. Now, people, here we got to know we have to divide our homepage into three parts. Correct? Now, people tell me, based on the navigation, just a second. Here, when I'm going to click to the sign up, right? We want something like this. The landing area has to be replaced with the sign up. Or with the login, or whatever the developer list is available, right? It should display or not?
Yes.
Jyoti, Purnima, Deepak, Harsh, people, are you following? Any questions?
Yes, Sabi.
Yeah. Shilpa, Karthik.
Yeah.
Okay. If we'll observe in this case, right? Now tell me, based on this requirement, right? Based on this requirement, should we follow? What do you think? Well, what do you think? Which approach we should follow? What do you think? Single page application or multi page application? Multi page, your traditional approach, right?
Single page.
We'll follow the, we are expected to use a or follow the single page application. Now, when you'll talk about the single page application, what would be the behavior? Now, depends on your navigation, right? Depends on your navigation, right? This landing content, it has to be replaced by register. It has to be, when I'll click on login, it has to be replaced by login. When I'll click to this developers, it has to be replaced by developer listing, correct? When I'll click on the developer again, then it should display the landing page or not, wherever we are.
That's right.
Correct. So this is what we are expecting. Now, if you want to develop the...
To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the 399 plan and grow your skills immensely.
SPA-based application, right? Single page application. In Angular, this thing is possible. This is point number one. Okay.
Abhibhai, default, like Angular is...
Yes,
there is single page application. No? By default,
We are going to use it. If you want, we can use multi page applications as well, Deepak. Hello.
Oh.
But the main expectation will be, SPA. But the point, if you want to use, we can. But the main motto of application, but the main motto of Angular, right, is used to SPA.
Okay. Thanks, Samir.
Right? Yeah. Next point. Now, people, we want to create this. Now, have a look over here. We will now to start our work, right? Do we need to create first these three parts or not? Header component, landing component, footer component. All of you agree with this? We have to design these three parts.
Yes.
And these three parts we have to combine somewhere else. Correct. How to do that? That is our next point. But now I have a basic question over here. Where should I create? Where should I create these three components? Where should I create these components? This is the major problem in front of me. This is a major problem in front of me. Okay, now to get the answer for this question, we will have a look over here. This is your application. Actually, my entire application is divided into these parts, you can say. We'll have a look over here. We will hear, are you able to see this profiles or not?
Yeah.
I will look over here. When you click to this, right, it's showing the complete profile details or not. Correct. Then another thing is you're right. Is it showing some experience details, correct? Post feeds, dashboard. Here we have these educational details, experience, correct or not? Correct, everyone. Now people tell me the entire my application requirement, did I split it into these parts or not? All of you agree with this?
Yes, Abhi.
Yeah.
Here, what I did, whatever the entire my application requirement is there, right? You can, I'm going to split it into these parts. Now, people tell me header header, landing and footer. People, what do you think? Where should I keep it? Header, landing and footer. Out of these three, header and footer, these are the commonly required stuff across the application or not?
That's true. Yeah.
Correct, everyone. So this is the commonly required stuff. What I'll do, this commonly required stuff, I'll keep it under my which bucket? I'll keep it under the core bucket. Is it clear or not?
Yes.
Did you get the point or not? Core bucket. Why am I referring the core bucket? Okay, your core is responsible for providing the basic services to all or not? For example, people, Spring Core Library. Spring Core Library is used in a boot also, is used in a REST also, everywhere it is used. It's going to provide the common functionalities throughout the other Spring frameworks or not? Like that, when we'll talk about the core, right? What this core will do? This core will provide the common functionalities to my application. All of you agree? Then, now people tell me, if I have a requirement of login and registration, where should I keep these two things? Tell me. Can I keep them into the core or can I keep it into somewhere else?
This is not required throughout the app, so cannot be under core. Okay.
That is not a common thing. Agree. True.
Yeah.
That is not a common thing, Vignesh. True. Agree. Prithvi, tell me, where should I keep this login and register then?
Under auth, like that's auth.
Correct. Auth is nothing but what? Your authentication. It means that whatever the authentication related stuff is required, we should keep it over there or not? All of you agree with this?
Yes.
Now, next point. Let's say I have some requirements to design the UI for create profile. People, have you observed the UI for these things or not? HTML pages, correct?
Yes.
Now people tell me, where should I keep these four now?
Under profile.
We'll keep them under the profile. Now, in your applications, right, you will have admin dashboard and we will have a user dashboard, agree?
Right.
And inside this
Just a second. Inside this admin dashboard, we'll have admin view. Admin reporting part something. In the same way, people, do we have user related part as well or not? That is a requirement. All of you agree with this or not? Okay, in short, once you landing to the, you know, once you land to the dashboard part, right, after login, people tell me, user and admin, will they get same level of UI or will they get different UI?
Different.
Agree? Different, now people tell me all this user-related UI and all the user-related UI and all the admin-related UI. Can I put it into the dashboard or can we have a one more level of segregation? Just Deepak.
One more level.
Sudhendra is saying one more level. Yes. Raghunanda, what do you think? Yes, Kiran. Sai Prabha. Yes, people, what do you think? Can we have everything into dashboard? Or there also, can we have a separation?
Admin can see all users, right? So maybe in admin dashboard, we'll have two separate views, one for user and a wrapper of user for admin. Something like
correct. That providing logically, that will do it, correct. But from the designing perspective, right? From the UI designing perspective, Prithvi, what I'm saying, the dashboard, right? Inside the dashboard, can we have two split ups or not? You're thinking from the accessibility perspective, correct?
Okay.
You got the point. You're thinking from the accessibility perspective. I'm talking from designing perspective. How to provide access for the admin, for the users, that is a different story. From the designing perspective, right? Admin related stuff and the user related stuff. Can I put it into the dashboard only, or can we have a split up for the same? Yes, Prithvi, what do you think?
A separate split up for view, and then we can refer in dashboard which view you want.
That is fine. But separation is required.
Yes.
Separation is required. Now people, if we'll look into our entire structure, right? If we look into our entire structure, people, this structure, is it pretty clean and clear? It has proper separations or segregations or not?
Yes.
Jyoti, Purnima, Deepak, did you get it?
Yes, Sabi.
Shilpa, Raghunanda.
Yes.
Sudhindra. Kiran. People, if you look into this part, right, the entire application, I have a proper split ups, right? Now, if I follow this thing, people tell me, can we perform ease of maintenance properly for my application or not? So through this, right, I can do the proper ease of maintenance for my application if I'll work in this way. Correct? Now, in this case, people, header, landing, and the footer. I'm going to highlight it with the
yellow color, create profile, update profile, delete and display. Again with the yellow color. Again, they are with the yellow color. The yellow colored one, are the UI parts or not?
Yes.
The yellow color are the UI parts, and the most important thing is your core, auth, profile, dashboard, post, comments part. I'm going to highlight it with the blue color. People, the blue colored stuff is referred as a module. The blue colored stuff is referred as a module. Now people tell me, before going to start the work, right, have we split up the things into specific buckets or not? In every bucket, what would be the expected functionalities that we are expecting? So this work we can do it, this work we can do it by implementing modularity in your application. So this core, auth, profile, dashboard, right, all these are the modules of your application. Yes, so in this way, right, we are going to apply the modularity in our Angular app. Yes, people, did you get the point? Did you get the understanding of this modularity or not? Now, inside this modularity, right, because of this separations, the things are a bit easy for accessing or not. Accessing and the development. Now, people tell me, if you have an issue with the profile part, correct, will it impact to other modules?
No.
What about that core module? Like that will get impacted, right, for any everything? Or is it
if any common things, Deepak, if any common thing is there, then it will be, which we are consuming it inside the profile, then it will be correct. From the, that would be a case to case call, correct?
Correct. Yeah.
That would be a case to case call. But now tell me, with if I'll follow this way, right? Deepak, tell me, can we write a clean and neatly code?
Yes, Abhi.
This split up is clear to you, everyone. Now, in this case, right, every part is referred as what? This blue colored are referred as the modules in Angular. Now, well, did you get the point? I have done completely reverse work, correct? I started the discussion from the application perspective, correct, everyone? We did the split ups on our requirement. We did the split ups in a proper way. And then finally, we come up with the solution called these parts are referred as the modules. Now, in Angular perspective, right? What do you mean by a module? A module is a container where we can hold components, services, pipes, directives, etc. People, this is your actual content of your 3 days, okay? These three things are the contents of your Angular course. So a module is nothing but what? A module is a container where we can hold all your components, services, pipes, directives, etc. Now, components are used for what purpose? UI purpose. services are used to handle the common business logic and to perform the REST API calls. Pipes are used for formatting or beautifications, or I would say that formatting and extraction. Directives can be used for to complete re-rendering or conditional based work. Now people, when you talk about a module, it's a container where we can declare components, services, pipes, directives, everything we can declare it inside a module. Now the most important thing, that is lazy modules. Now people tell me, now people think from the flow perspective. When you hit this application, now tell me here over this page, right? Which module will come? Tell me.
Authorization.
No, Deepak. Over the UI, right? Which contents are rendered? Navbar, landing, footer. Agree?
Yes.
Now, who will come into the picture? Tell me.
Land.
Core module will come into the picture as per our discussion, correct?
Yeah, core.
Deepak, did you get the point? Vidya, correct. Core module will come into the picture.
Yeah, core will come.
Yes.
Gajalakshmi, Purnima, Jyoti, Balaji, is it clear? Vignesh. So in this case, right, who will come into the picture? People, if you you can ping me over the chat also, right? I'm fine with that, okay? But somewhere you please communicate, okay? That is most important thing for me, because see, another half an hour, right, I will ask for every minute, right? Most probably I will ask you, did you get this point or not? Please be responsive for the next half an hour, because this part is a bit crucial, okay? This part is a bit crucial. That's the reason I'm asking everyone. So in this case, right, if you'll observe now over the UI, right, now here, what do you think? Which module will come?
Here, the core module.
Look at the core module, right? Now, when I'll click to this sign up, which module you will get it now? Which modules are used? Header is there, footer is there. People, header is still there, right? And footer is still there, right? So core module is there. Core module is already used over here. Agree? And this register part is from which module? This register part is coming from the auth module, right? So now people tell me, when I'll click on this sign up, it means that we are going to perform some auth module related activity or not? We are going to perform some auth module related activity or not? All of you agree with this?
Yeah.
Correct. That means when I'm going to click on this sign up, then and only then we are expecting it should load the auth module content. Otherwise, it should not.
That's right.
Now people tell me, here, am I coming with this expectation? Whenever a particular module is required, at that time only, am I expecting that particular module has to be loaded? Correct, everyone?
Yes.
Now, that's right.
This thing will help us to improve the performance of your application or not?
whatever the things are required, bring those things into the picture. Otherwise, don't bring the unnecessary contents. This one will help us to improve the performance. All of you agree with this or not? Now, to do this thing, here we have to follow which aspect? We have to follow the modularity aspect. And in Angular, we can load the modules lazily. In Angular, we can load the modules lazily. How to load the modules lazily? How to load it statically, right? All that part, I'll show it to you. Practically, I'll show it to you. But first of all, did you get the clarity regarding the component and the modules or not? That is the most important thing for me. What do you mean by a module? And what do you mean by a component? People, are you able to draw the line in between?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay, now, as per the expectation. Now, I'll refer that diagram so that you'll get the clarity. Now, people tell me this header, landing, footer, these three components, we want to create it. But under which module? Under the core module or not? Now, people tell me for that purpose, first, do we need to create a module or not? And then I can go for the component creation or not?
Yes.
Practically, practically. What is our expectation? These three components should be a part of the core module. Because if core module is not available, then how can I create the components? So for that purpose, we need to understand how to create a component, everyone. So for that purpose, I'm going to write a command. ng generate module core --, routing. Well, I'll command just a second. I'll just write the description. What is the use of routing, right? I will explain you after the lunch, okay? But as of now, I'm going to specify this thing. But what is routing and how to use it, you will get to know practically by today itself. Have some patience till post lunch, okay? Then people, is there any need to explain what is this ng now?
Angular
only, right? Generate m core --, routing. Oh, just a second. G stands for generate. Okay. M stands for module. Module name. Use to handle lazy loading. This routing only, right, will help us for handling the lazy loading. How it will help us and all, right? That story we'll discuss. Okay. That is not a problem. But people, did you get the understanding for this command or not? ng stands for Angular, g stands for generate, m stands for module. Which module we want to create it, everyone?
Please enroll our general membership for $399 plan to get access of all the parts.
Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps-related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click on to the join button, select the $399 plan, and grow your skills immensely.
Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest.
Thanks for watching.